All right, greetings. Preacher John here, Boulder, Colorado. We're at Folsom and Valemont. That's where we are today. That's Folsom right here, where that white pickup just turned. This is kind of the inner part of Boulder. It's kind of an old suburb. Right across the street is the Unity Church, right over there. And this road right here is Valemont. It's one of the main arteries on the northern end of Boulder. And then up this road here on it goes into a trailhead that goes all the way, kind of meets all the trails here in Boulder. It's really a great little location. Today is really sunny. You can't see it in the video, but right over there you can see all the mountains. It's pretty cool. And I'm right here in front of a 7-Eleven store, but it looks like they've shut it down for the day or two, and they are rebuilding it. A lot of stores are doing some rebuilding. God bless you, man. See, so, you know, we get the mockers right away. So I'm a few minutes late again today. I worked till 12:30 last night on the ministry. Preached for 5 hours, then got ready and left at 6. Whoa, the wind. Then left at 6:30 to do a Bible study, house church, and didn't get home till about 9:30 or so, 10 o'clock. And then I started doing my video editing and was done about 12:30 or 1 o'clock this morning. And then I had to update a lot of stuff this morning. So, you know, we're working around the clock. We're putting in about 55 hours in the ministry. Sometimes I hit 60. Tomorrow is Friday. It will be, this is April 1st. God bless April. So this right here is, so tomorrow's Friday, and I will be in Denver the first Friday of the month. I'm down at 17th and Wine Coop, directly in front of Union Station, the Amtrak Union Station. And the Lord has directed me to stay till dark. I get there about 10 in the morning, and normally my schedule is to be off at 5 o'clock, 10 to 5, 7 hours. But the Lord has asked me to stay till dark. Friday is the traditional Good Friday where Jesus was crucified on the cross. It's the traditional day we celebrate. I know a lot of people say it might have been on Wednesday or Thursday. They give you all these dates. But God knows the exact date, but we honor it. So today I'm lifting up Jesus Christ. And Jesus said that if I be lifted up above the earth, I will draw all men unto me. And that was Jesus speaking. So I'm lifting Jesus up, and I'm proclaiming the Lord Jesus Christ as Savior. And whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. And if you're not saved, just give Jesus a call. His number is Romans 10:13, Acts 2:21. He's got a lot of numbers. And you can, you know, just pick out one of them. I like Romans 10:13. I use Romans a lot because I call that the book for truckers, because I was a trucker for 40 years, and I would say instead of the Romans road, I would say that's the trucker's road. That's the trucker's road. But so I'm going to stay till dark, and then Saturday is my Sabbath. I rest in the Lord like He asked me to several years ago. I don't go to a different feast. I don't do anything special. My special thing is to rest in the Lord Jesus Christ. And I spend the entire day with Jesus. Hallelujah for that. That is such a fantastic thing. I'm so blessed to have that set aside by the Holy Ghost. And then on Sunday will be Easter. It's the day that we celebrate the resurrection of Christ. And a lot of people also complain about that date being wrong, but that's the day we've set aside, and God still honors it. And as long as God still honors it, we'll keep doing that. If He wanted to switch it to a different day, guess what He would do? Since God owns it all, and He's the Lord of this world, He's the Creator, He would have changed it. But we celebrate that day, Easter, as the resurrection of Jesus Christ. And on that day, I start at 10 o'clock in the morning at 28th and Pearl here in Boulder. And the Lord also directed me for that particular day also to stay till dark. So I'll stay till dark. But right now, I wish this wind would come down so I can read this Bible verse. I got a Bible verse right here. I just ministered to... I'm struggling with my prayer book, man. Guys, keep me in prayer for my prayer book. I am still struggling with my prayer book. I lift everybody up, but on an individual, personalized basis to go through every single name. Like, I'm almost around 500 names, and I'm just really struggling with that. I don't know how Paul did it, but I'm really, really struggling with that, and I'm hoping that God will allow me to overcome the struggle. So I want to be an overcomer. All right, the wind has just stopped, so let me read this Bible verse. I got to do this between wind gusts. It's Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. So Luke is where we want to go. It's the third gospel, Luke chapter 6. So Luke chapter 6, Jesus is talking. He has a great sermon all the way through there. You can see it. But when you get down to verse 38, he says this, give, G-I-V-E, give, comma, give. So he makes a declaration, give to all the people. Tell the people to give. And, whoa, here comes the wind again. Just hang on a second. I'm going to lay this down for a second. I can't do this in the wind. Sorry. I'm going to lay it down right there. Sorry. I do the best I can with what I got. Bolder wind in March, April, I guess, is really hot. See, now the wind stopped. But I need two hands. But to hold the camera, hold the Bible, hold the banner, and carry on a conversation is not always easy. But I'm right here. People are looking straight at me. They're coming up Folsom, and they're looking right at me. Anyways, I'm going to read this Bible verse here. The Bible verse says, give. Okay? Don't you just love that? Give. That's like Jesus says, forgive. Give. You know, preach. You know, minister. Be filled. turn the other cheek. You know, he tells you all kinds of things. But here he says, give. Okay? And this is what's going to happen after you do that. So it doesn't happen before you give, it happens after you give. Now, a lot of people, preachers in the prosperity movement, called it, you know, they always talked about money. And, you know, money is just a tiny sliver of our life. Even though we spend 2,000 hours a year dedicated to earning money, but, you know, that's how God put it up, and we do it, we work hard. Farmers even work longer. And, you know, I'll log more than 2,000 hours. I'll probably log close to 3,000 hours this year. See, 60 times 5, yeah, 3,000 hours. So so I'm giving my time. I gave a gospel tract. So I gave the gospel, and then I gave I donated my financing to a guy on the street here. So I give. I give time. I give the gospel. I give funding to people. I donate, and I'm always doing whatever. I give my prayers. I give my my physical self right here. I give. So right here. So there's a bunch of guys looking over here at me. So let's go back into the Bible here. It says give, and that's everything. That keys off another verse that I'm going to put in the video. I didn't look it up because I didn't want to go to all these verses. I knew it was going to be windy. But it says God will not be mocked. Whatsoever a man gives. Okay, whatsoever a man gives, that's male or female, whatsoever a man gives, that shall he reap. Or that shall, reap. And I'll put the verse here so you can kind of see it. But let's go back to Luke 6, 38. Give, and it shall be given unto you. Okay, so you give and it comes back. That's called giving and receiving. Okay, give and it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down and shaken together, and running over, shall people, male and female, boys and girls, men, okay? Shall men give unto your bosom, and to you, okay? For with the same measure, see, that's the key, the same measure that you're doling out your time, that you're doling out your prayers, that you're logging, whatever you're doing for the world, for Christ here in the world, whatever you're doing for mankind, that same type of measure, like I'm giving my all. I'm giving everything. So that same measure God pours back to me. That's why I am not lacking anything. I am abundantly supplied in everything I need. I've got an abundance of the messages of God. I'm not short on sermons. I've got so many sermons, I haven't got time to give all the sermons. So I'm abundantly blessed in sermons. I'm abundantly blessed in prayers. I'm abundantly blessed financially. Home, housing, travel, everything I need, God is abundantly supplying because I'm giving it all. As I give it all, God gives His all back to me. Because the same measure, right? Same measure. So look at the measure that you're using. All right, look at the same measure you're using. So with the same measure, how you do it, God's gonna do it, okay? You gotta get that. A lot of people don't get that. They think, if I just give a tiny, tiny bit, then God's gonna pour it over to me. God's not gonna do that. He's gonna give it the same measure that you're giving, okay? So the same measure that you meet with, it shall be measured to you again. There's a little King James versions in there, so I'll say it in the King James English. For the same measure that ye, that's all of you, Y-E, all of us, not just one or two, not just the givers, not just the tithers, not just those who feel led to call to give, is everyone. Every believer, every child of God is he's talking to. For with the same measure that ye meet with all, it shall be measured. It shall be measured. It's like, it's a given. God will not be mocked. For it shall be measured to you again. To you, back to you. So the word of God is true. The word is not false. It will not return void. God watches over his word, making sure it'll perform what it was sent out to do. So what happens is a lot of people don't know what's in this book. They make it up. They make it up. They hear somebody else talk. They hear some street preacher, like myself, and they don't know what's going on. So, and they read a book, or they read a sermon, or they listen to some song, and they create some sort of imaginary gospel in their mind. And that's why I like when Paul was preaching to the Bereans, they sought the scriptures, they searched the scriptures, they went to the word of God after Paul would preach, and they would go through the scriptures, because what Paul was preaching was not what they were used to. This is all new stuff. He was building the New Testament by the power of the Holy Ghost, which is what we read today. So they searched the scriptures. They searched the scriptures. God bless you, man. So there's a bunch of mockers there telling me I should go feed the poor. Well, I do feed the poor. So right here is the word of God. And there are always going to be mockers because we're in the end times, okay? So praise God for that. See, it gets me kind of messed up a little bit. But I just say, God bless you. Thank you so much. So Lord, I just thank you that the word of God is being sowed into the hearts and minds of the people watching this video. I thank you, Lord, that what's going on in their minds is the desire to receive the word of God, to learn the word of truth, to listen to the Holy Spirit, to be taught by the Holy Ghost so that they can be filled with the Holy Ghost, to be powerful ministers of Jesus Christ, to be servants of God, to be ordained an elder in the city that they live, the state that they live, the country where they live. And Lord, I just thank you right now for what you are doing in their life, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise God. All right, man. I love you. Take care, all right? We'll see you on the streets and on tomorrow in Denver. God bless you. I love you, man. Bye-bye.